In this edition of Inside Blue Hose Football, Presbyterian College takes on another ranked opponent coming from our conference. It's also the team that makes up the Palmetto State Traditional. We'll have the highlights of Charleston Southern, have a visit with the coach, and a lot more in this off-week edition of Inside Blue Hose Football.
Inside Blue Hose Football is brought to you by Founders Federal Credit Union. Relax, you're with Founders. By Self Regional Healthcare, we bring advanced care closer. By Fats Cafe of Clinton, making your tailgate deliciously easy. And by Coca-Cola, the official soft drink of Presbyterian College.
We welcome you in to this off-week edition of Inside Blue Hose Football, along with the coach, Harold Nichols. Mm-hmm. I'm Eric Thacker. Homecoming crowd last Saturday was one of the best in Presbyterian College history, and why not? The Blue Hose, competitive each and every week on the gridiron, gorgeous weather, and some outstanding football from both teams. Coach, I'll say it again. Mm-hmm. Your kids got out there, even though we didn't win the contest, mm-hmm. they fought hard, and for seven out of the last eight quarters of football against the Buccaneers, mm-hmm. the defense put shutouts in seven of those quarters.
Yeah, it was another close game. You know, I feel like that we get on the show each and every week and we talk about the same scenario.
Right.
Very frustrating. You know, credit goes to Charleston Southern. You know, they're the ones that made the plays to win the game. Mm-hmm. I do think our kids played well. I think they played with great effort throughout the course of the game. You know, we got some kids on our football team that have unbelievable football character that answer the bell, and mm-hmm. been really proud of the way that they've played. They've been consistent all year, you know, as far as an effort and attitude kind of standpoint. Now, we've got to execute better at times. There's no doubt about it, and that's the frustrating part about it, because you get into a scenario of where your margin's small, and you got to be able to make plays at certain times of the game, and you know, we're not making those right now. We've got to figure it out. We've got to find a way to make those plays, and that's what we're hard at work doing right now. But hopefully we can get some things figured out here in the open week.
Your thoughts on the homecoming crowd and all of the celebration around Presbyterian College campus? I know it's important to you. That's why I ask.
Well, Eric, I tell you, you know, you bring up a really good point. You know, that's the thing that Presbyterian College is. You know, everybody loves coming back home to their alma mater, and it's a place that I love, and, you know, you can kind of feel that energy when they come back. And, I mean, you couldn't put another car in the parking lot out there, and it was just a great atmosphere, great crowd. I want to thank all the people back home that have come back and have shared in that experience, and just, you know, makes it a great atmosphere for our kids. And that's what Division I football is here at PC, and to be able to watch these kind of contests and give our fans and alumni something to cheer about. And so really thankful for all of them. It's a great day, great weather, you know, and really something really good to be a part of.
Special shout out to Alex Skull and Taylor Cook of the Scotsman Club, who had the rally towels, and a special thank you to Julia Skipper, the proprietor of McDonald's locally here in Clinton, who is the sponsor of our cowbells. Great atmosphere. Well, Coach, let us go ahead and dive in and take a look at the highlights, beginning with the offense first.
Game highlights are brought to you by Matt Davis State Farm Insurance. Like a good neighbor, Matt Davis and State Farm are there.
Here we are, finally mounted a drive here in the second quarter. Come out and got our two tight ends in the game, and I think this is a touchdown run by Daryl. Does a nice job sealing the edge, and Daryl uses his speed and gets outside. You can see right here from the end zone view, you know, Joe and Riley do a good job. There's Austin Allen out there blocking, and I think that's Darquez Watson there in the end zone.
We get blocks
in there and get a touchdown. Here we are back in a two tight end set. You know, we tried to do some things there to help us a little bit in the box. Got a little counter play, and there's Daryl breaking a couple of tackles and getting down the sideline for a big gain. He had another good day for us. Here's an end zone shot of it. Again, you know, credit goes to Charleston Southern. They had an awful good defensive football team. I think they were ranked second in the country in total defense. And, you know, for our guys to get out there, there's Ryan Rayleigh and Joe Perter and those guys getting out there and leading Daryl on a nice gain. Here we have another little handoff right there. You see Daryl hitting the hole and getting a big gainer there. this is a little bit of a deceiving play because they were a little looser and were hoping to try to spring Darrell for the first down, backed up in our own end here, run a little zone play, and Darrell makes the linebacker miss and breaks another tackle with the safety and makes a nice gain right there. They try to run linebackers through all day. We finally get a good pitch and catch right here with Trayvon Howell and Caleb Griffin here off the fake to the back. There's an end zone shot of it. Do a good job protecting right here and get it all cut down. And Caleb throws a nice throw and nice catch by Trayvon right there. Here's another play we got going in. I think it might have been on that same drive and got a little swing route out here to A.C. Palmer. And there's Devron Glenn and Darquez out in front blocking. Get down there inside the 5-yard line with a first and goal. Good play right here. See A.C. coming in motion here from your left to your right of your screen. And Caleb does a nice job spitting it out there to him. And A.C. breaks a couple tackles and works in there for the first and goal inside the 5. Good job by A.C.
Well, Coach, one bright spot of the offense. Well, a couple, actually. We see the offensive line improving. But let us give some love to Darrell Bridges because this guy is emerging as one of the best running backs, if not the best running back in the conference. He's second in rushing, but that's behind Kennesaw State, the Owls quarterback. Mm-hmm. So in terms of the running back position, he's performing the best right now in the conference.
Yeah, I think you make two good points. One, I think our offensive line is improving. Right. We're getting better each and every week. We're young up there. We're gelling together. But Darrell's been productive all year. He's had, like I say, you know, he's had a great offseason, really prepared his body for this. So he has been a very productive player. Knock on wood, I hope he can kind of stay healthy and keep going because he's a big part of what we're doing.
And we still have a lot of football left. This is the off week. Later in the show, I'll talk to Coach and get his thoughts on how the team prepares during the off week and see if we're going to have some other faces as part of the offense. But that's down the road. First, let us go ahead and take a timeout. When we come back, we'll take a look at the defense and the special teams. They played superb again for the Blue Hose.
This portion of Inside Blue Hose Football is brought to you by Matt Davis State Farm Insurance of Clinton. Like a good neighbor, Matt Davis and State Farm are there. Cooper Motor Company, sales and service of Chrysler, Jeep, Dodge, and Ram trucks since 1938. Chick-fil-A of Lawrence, home of the original chicken sandwich.
We're fighting cancer with caring, with technology, with knowledge. And now, with the Hollings Clinical Trial Network at the Medical University of South Carolina. Together, we're bringing more advanced cancer care close to home. Self-Regional Healthcare Cancer Center. We bring advanced care closer.
Hi, this is Harold Nichols, head football coach here at Presbyterian College. Do you need some help simplifying your life? Matt Davis has helped me, and he can help you too. Go see Matt Davis and his great team at State Farm in Clinton, South Carolina. They will handle your auto, home, and life insurance so you will have more time to handle everything else in life. You could earn discounts up to 40%. Sounds like a touchdown to me.
We welcome you back to Inside Blue Hose Football. The defense played outstanding again in front of a homecoming crowd. Let us go ahead and take a look at the defensive highlights along with special teams.
Game highlights are brought to you by Matt Davis State Farm Insurance. Like a good neighbor, Matt Davis and State Farm are there.
Here we have the defensive highlights. Sure was a lot of these today. You know, probably could have ran about 10 minutes of these clips. These kids really played hard and really held a really good offense down. Here they come. They got a little play-action pass, and there's I think it's Obina Tesawe, who just continues to keep getting better each and every week. And I think this is a really good play by him. I think he's up and under on the guard right here. They got a little play-action pass trying to hit the tight end up the seam here. There's Obina slipping off, and big sack by Obina right there, tackle for loss. Try to keep him behind the sticks some on first and second down. That really helped us at times. Here they're on a twin set, split backfield like they normally are. Bring a little pressure from the field, and there's Deron Dickey right there. Nice play by Deron. You know, he's been solid all year long. And we kind of set him up to the field right here. Got a little slant by the back. He kind of nice through, makes a big play on the quarterback. Another tackle for loss by Deron Dickey. Here they are again, twin set, split backfield. You know, like we prepared for. They got a little G play right there, and there's Mitchell Anderson making a nice play up and under on the center. You know, they had a hard time getting anything going inside in the middle.
Yeah, we defended the bellies really well.
And, you know, that's kind of a staple of their offense, too. You know, and that's something we need to do a nice job of. There's Mitchell Anderson coming, playing off the center right there. Nice job by him. Again, twin set to the field, split backs. You know, that was kind of their formation of choice. They got a little loaded option. There's Uganda Aiko playing off of it, Deron Dickey. And then we got a corner that comes off up there. I think it might have been Steve. But, you know, Uganda does a nice job playing off of the linemen, staying alive. And there's Deron Dickey right where he needs to be, and we get a nice stop right there. Here we are again. That they're kind of a tight end weak set here with one back. They bring a guy in, entering back in the in. They're trying to read Uganda. That's a hard thing to do because he's so long and quick. You know, they read a lot of their ends and stuff and some of their options that they do. And there's Uganda right there. Nice job kind of sifting it out, making a big play for a tackle for loss. Here you have the special teams highlights. I think this is the extra point. Try to get something cooking here with a kind of a unique formation.
Swinging gate.
Yeah, a little swinging gate right here. But, you know, really proud of Brett. You know, he's come on the last couple, 3 weeks and done a nice job kicking, got the ball up. You know, it's a big part of college football is be able to have good operation between the snapper, the holder, and the kicker. And he does a nice job getting the ball up, had pretty decent protection right here. Get a little penetration to the right, but like I said, we got good operation right there and able to get it done. So good job by Brett. Here we are. We're in kind of a punt safe look with our defense out there, and they had a unique way of kicking the ball kind of sideways here. And so it was a challenge for us to kind of get lined up. You know, it was a unique deal because, you know, they would always roll kick and rugby kick. So we had to make sure we took care of all the eligibles. We kept our defense out there most of the game when they did it. You know, got Deshaun Davis, who's a true freshman back there, you know, hopefully making good decisions. And they didn't get a lot of yardage out of it. But it was just a unique look that we had to make sure we took care of.
Well, we welcome you back to Inside Blue Hose Football. Now let's talk about the defense. Coach, we say it each and every week, this defensive front, both platoons, are outstanding. And the linebacker play, and now the defensive secondary, though young, getting better and better. Hats off to your defense again, Coach.
Oh, man, there's no question about it. Those guys played outstanding. You know, you can't really ask too much more out of them. You know, I wish they'd have held them to three instead of giving them that touchdown there at the end, you know, but for the most part, they played outstanding. And, you know, they've done everything that we've asked them, you know, keeping us in ball games, getting turnovers. I mean, they've been outstanding. A lot of credit goes to Coach Pango and his staff over there. They do a great job and getting those kids prepared week in and week out. And, you know, those guys up front keep battling, keep competing, yes, you know, and do. I'm really proud of them. So, but yeah, you can't say enough good things about that defense.
13 points in 8 quarters against the Presbyterian College defense, yielding only 1 touchdown. That touchdown did prove to be the difference, but let's applaud that defense because now for 2 years they've been playing lights out. Now let's talk about special teams. This is another part of the Blue Hose that have been well improved.
Well, you know, you think this, you know, we had we did good net punting. Our coverage units were pretty good. We need to get better on kickoff return. You know, we need to try to set up our offense a little bit with better field position. But overall, I think they've been executing, doing some good things. You can't have any defects in a kicking game. You know, it gives you a chance to stay in the game and you play the game the right way. And I've been real proud of the most part. I thought Steven had a good day punting. You know, killed it inside the 23 times. So, making some progress there. We just got to keep battling.
And I wanted to mention again, great game for Steven Dorr. Real quick, Coach, we're seeing the punting game in collegiate football going through a metamorphosis. There's some Australian kickers coming in that play Australian rules, but now this rugby-style rollout, end-over-end kick. What are we seeing here?
Well, I think, you know, teams can really attack the launch point for punters. You know, you see it in the NFL, you know, they're not rugbying as much, but they're all setting their launch point, you know, mm-hmm. and snappers are good enough that they can snap it here and there. But for us, I think, if you start bringing 2, 3, 4, 5 guys to the shield, you got to move that launch point some. You give them a little different angle. And so we did that as a little change up in the game. But you're seeing more and more teams doing that. It's awkward for the returner. So there's some advantages to doing it out of spread punt.
Well, one of the favorite parts of this show is our Nichols Automotive Collision of the Week. Nichols Automotive, your home for all of your automotive needs, including Yokohama tires.
Here we have the Nichols Automotive Collision of the Week. Kind of preface it a little bit. This is Obina Tasawe here at the defensive tackle, kind of slips off the guard, and bam, big play, big tackle for loss. I really like those tackle for loss, like those big guys in the middle making plays like this. And this is the Nichols Automotive Collision of the Week. You'll see the end zone shot of it. He'll play right off of the center here, tracks the quarterback, bam, big play, tackle for loss. Nichols Automotive Collision of the Week.
Again, a quarterback sack is part of the Nichols Automotive Collision of the Week. Those are the best kind. Now let us transition to the Palmetto Bone and Joint Injury Report. And Coach, if I'm not mistaken, I think we came out of this ball game relatively healthy.
Yeah, we did. You know, I think that we missed some receivers. You know, Jordan Howells was hurt, Markell was hurt, DJ Wilson was hurt. All three of those kids didn't play. We're still missing Cam Mack. You know, hopefully we'll be able to get him here after the open week. We were finally able to get Snoop Byers on the field Saturday.
That
you know,
was nice.
So Bristow was hurt, did not play in the game. So that hurt us a little bit offensively, I think, you know, losing some of those guys. But, you know, it's that time of the year. You know, you're in the seventh, eighth week of the season. And so hopefully Doc's over there at Palmetto Bone Joint can get those guys healthy and get them back to us.
Those injuries a week ago, but nothing new this week.
No, I think we're going to be okay. You know, this open date comes at a really good time, so we're able to heal some of them, you know, nicks and dings that we got and get those guys back ready for the Gardner-Webb game in 2 weeks.
Absolutely. Still a lot of football to be played. Coach, you mentioned it about the off week. We'll talk about what you, your coaching staff, and what the players do during that off week. We'll also have another visit with Coach on Coach's Corner. That's all ahead here. Inside Blue Hose Football.
I'm a random windstorm. Shaky, 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 shaky. Shaky, shaky. And if you got cut rate insurance, you could be picking up this tab yourself. So get Allstate. You could save some cash and be better protected from mayhem like me.
We're fighting cancer with caring, with technology, with knowledge, and now with the Hollings Clinical Trial Network at the Medical University of South Carolina. Together, we're bringing more advanced cancer care close to home. Self-Regional Healthcare Cancer Center. We bring advanced care closer.
As you set your financial game plan, we'll be with you every play. Relax, you're with Founders.
There once was a family, a lot like this one, and they were traveling far away where there were no Bojangles. The family needed breakfast, but they got a late start. They pulled up to a drive-thru of a strange restaurant, and a loud voice boomed. We stopped serving breakfast at 10 a.m.
Oh, honey.
At Bojangles, we've always served breakfast all day. Come in for a Cajun filet biscuit today. Bojangles, it's bow time.
Hi, this is Harold Nichols, head football coach here at Presbyterian College. Do you need some help simplifying your life? Matt Davis has helped me, and he can help you too. Go see Matt Davis and his great team at State Farm in Clinton, South Carolina. They will handle your auto, home, and life insurance so you will have more time to handle everything else in life. You could earn discounts up to 40%. Sounds like a touchdown to me.
This portion of Inside Blue Hose Football is brought to you by Bojangles, it's bow time. And by Jeff Smith, Allstate Insurance of Clinton. You're in good hands with Jeff Smith and Allstate.
Well, we welcome you back. Now it's time to learn part of the game or the strategy of football, Coach's Corner.
Coach's Corner is brought to you by Jeff Smith, Allstate Insurance of Clinton. You're in good hands with Allstate and Jeff Smith.
Welcome to this week's edition of Coach's Corner. I've got Stephen Doer here. He's a senior punter from Landrum High School up in Landrum, South Carolina. And this week we're going to talk about ball security and the importance of that. That's one thing last year that we did a really, really good job of was taking care of the football on offense and doing a good job of getting takeaways on defense. I'm going to talk to you about the proper way to secure a football when you're running with it. Okay, Stephen's going to take the football here, and it's really a four-point process. All right, the first point goes, you need to have a great eagle claw, all right, on the tip of the ball right there to make sure you secure it. The second point of pressure, you need to make sure it goes to the forearm right here, all right? So you got a point of pressure here at the tip of the football, point of pressure there at the meat, right there at the forearm. The third is the bicep, okay? Making sure that's nice and secure right there in the bicep. The fourth point of pressure goes to the rib cage. Now, it's really important. We talk to all of our backs and receivers and quarterbacks when they're running with the football to chin the ball. So we want to make sure that we chin the football, make sure it's up closer to our chin. So we've got good ball security right there, all right? You notice that looking from the back, you know, you cannot really see the football here. You don't want any of the football back behind so a defender can come and punt. And when he comes and rips, he's got to go through the arm, got to go through the bicep to get the football out. Now, obviously, if you're running with the ball inside the tackle box or in traffic, we teach our backs to secure the ball with two hands, all right? And keep the ball with two hands going through, because when you go through the tackle box, there's a lot of people pulling and punching at the football to try to get it out. The football is the most valuable piece of property that we have, okay? And so on Saturdays, we try to do a good job of taking care of the ball. Thanks to Stephen Doer, and that's this week's edition of Coach's Corner.
Well, once again, thank you, Coach. Now let us take a look at what's going on next week for the Blue Hose, brought to you by Chick-fil-A of Lawrence.
Next week's preview is sponsored by Chick-fil-A of Lawrence, home of the original chicken sandwich.
All righty, Coach, the off week. What do you, your coaching staff, and the players get done this week?
Well, I think it's probably threefold. I think, one, you get a chance to get some guys healthy. You know, these last two or three weeks have been some really battles, hard-fought games, very physical football games. So get some of those guys back healthy for the stretch run over this last four games of the season. I think, secondly, you get a chance to kind of develop some of the younger players, kind of go back to fundamentals again. So you're not necessarily preparing for a game this week, but you're able to kind of work on yourself a little bit, do a little self-study, Get yourself going there. And I think third is you're able to kind of, you know, pick up recruiting a little bit. You know, these last couple, three home games, we've had a lot of recruits back on campus, a lot of really good players. Allow our coaches some time to get out and kind of reestablish some of those high school relations that we have. And so it'll be kind of a threefold thing. It'd be a good respite for the coaches, you know, to be able to kind of refresh their minds and get ready for a good Gardner Webb team.
All righty, Coach. Thank you very much. Mm-hmm. I want to remind you fans that I had the pleasure of talking to a few of the players after the homecoming game last week. They were so encouraged by the turnout. That means come on out. There's still a lot of football left to be played. You can be part of it. For the coach, Harold Nichols, I'm Eric Thacker. Till next week, go Blue Hose.
Inside Blue Hose Football was brought to you by Smith Chevrolet of Lawrence, providing premier new car sales and service in Lawrence for over 60 years. By Palmetto Bone & Joint, the official orthopedic care provider for PC Athletics. And by Carolina Fresh Farms, the official turf grass of Presbyterian College. We would like to thank the following Blue Hose Honor Roll sponsors: The Bud Group, Good Times Entertainment, Carolina Concrete, Enterprise Rent-A-Car, Midway Barbecue, Hanna Heating and Air Conditioning, Epting Turf and Tractor, Arthur State Bank, Carolina Auto Sales of Clinton, Wilson's Cafe, Tony's Pizza, and Steamer's Cafe.